Hi friends, this is Akash and today I will take you to Isa Khan's tomb. To reach Isa Khan's tomb, one can go by their own private vehicle or take metro. The nearby metro station is Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, JLN, and from there the distance is only 1.5 kilometers, which is hardly 10 to 15 minutes depending on the traffic situation. The cost of the fare will be 70 to 80 rupees depending on the local rates and how much you bargain with the auto driver. Also, one can go to the tomb by their own vehicle, and for vehicles there is a parking facility available next to the tomb, almost 200 meters from the entrance, and the parking fare will depends 20 rupees per hour or 40 rupees for 3 hours. Isa Khan was born in 1529 on 18th August. He was a Muslim Rajput Zamindar who was one of the Barrow Bullion's 12 landlords and a Zamindar of Khirjpur in 16th century Bengal. Throughout his reign, he resisted the Mughal Empire invasion. It was only after his death that the region fell totally under Mughal control. Isa Khan tomb is located next to Humayun's tomb, New Delhi. Tomb of the noble Isa Khan Niazi is located in the Humayun tomb complex in Delhi, India. The mausoleum, octagonal in shape and built mainly of red sandstone, was built in 1547-1548 during the reign of Sher Shah Suri. The mosque of Isa Khan is located west of the mausoleum, which along with other buildings form the UNESCO World Heritage Site of the Humayun tomb complex. The history of mausoleum houses the tomb of the Isa Khan Niazi, who was a noble at the court of Sher Shah Suri and Islam Shah Suri. It is situated south of the Bu Halima's garden in the Humayun tomb complex. An inscription at the tomb mentions that it was built in 1547-1548. It also says the tomb is an asylum of paradise built during the reign of Sher Shah. The mosque located west of mausoleum was built in 1547. Comprehensive restoration work was done throughout the Aga Khan Trust for Culture, AKTC, in collaboration with Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, in 2011-2015. The architect of mausoleum. The tomb was constructed in Lodi architecture style. Its octagonal shape, the hallmark of Lodi era, stands on a low plinth veranda surrounded the central chamber. Each side of the chamber consists of three arches from the chajja roof present over each. The mausoleum architecture style is similar to those of Mubarak Shah, Muhammad Shah, Khan-e-Jahan, Telangani, and Sikandar Lodi. The mausoleum is built mainly with grey quartzite with red sandstone used for ornamentation. Stucco plaster envelopes the rough masonry. Different colored tiles have been used in walls for decoration. The tomb's gateway stands on a 1 meter high 3.3 feet podium reached by stairs. The square head doorway of gate chamber has been built in Hindu architecture style. Inside the mausoleum, the tomb is enclosed by an inner octagonal wall. Other than the southern and western walls, the other walls consist of jalis, which are recessed. These recesses in turn contain four central arches. The western wall has the main mihrab, a semicircular niche in the wall which indicates the direction of Mecca, the direction of which the Muslim pray. The mihrab is four central bordered by Quranic verses. The southern wall includes the entrance to the tomb. The medallion located at the center of the dome is ornamented with Persian floral design. It also has a Quranic verses. The dome chamber consists of six tombs, two large and four smaller sandstones. Slabs are used to pave the floor. The cenotaph of Isa Khan Niaz is made of red sandstone and marble. Mosque. The central dome resembles of the Qila-e-Khuna Mosque at Purana Qila. The side domes are raised of the pillars and resemble pavilions. The single prayer chamber is divided into three bays. The mosque central bay is made of red sandstone, the side bays of grey stone. Each bay houses a four-arched gateway to the mosque, whose borders are decorated with green blue tiles. The corners of central bay are adorned with pinnacles. According to Archaeological Survey of India, the mosque is simpler in comparison to mausoleum. There are three equal side arches on each facade, supported by stone pilasters. Blue and green tile border the arches. A frame made of red stone contains the central arch. These features were inspired by Moth Ki Masjid Mosque in Delhi. The side arches are made of grey stone and decorated with stucco. The medallion on the spandrels of these arches contain floral design inlaid with blue and green tiles, a feature of Moorish architecture. The mosque stands on 1 meter high, 3.3 feet platform. Its interior is plain and the floor is simply plastered. The lateral dome are built on pendentives, while the central dome rises from squinches on a 16-sided drum. Its pavilion, supported by stone pillars, are adorned with blue tiles. The mosque contains three mihrabs of equal size carved of stones containing calligraphy. Isa Khan Tomb's garden tomb predates Humayun tomb by two decades and is culmination of an architectural style used for royal tombs in Delhi during the Sayyid and Lodi dynasty from the early 15th to the early 16th century. It is the only surviving octagonal enclosed tomb complex with walls, mosque and gateway intact. Conservation work at the site commenced in January 2011 following extensive documentation including 3D high-definition surveying, condition assessment, archival research and a peer review of conversation plane. An enormous amount of work was required to remove some 3,25,000 cubic feet of earth from the site in order to restore the landscape to its original level, while being carefully not to destroy any archaeology. Conservation and landscape works are carried out with due care of authenticity of material and building tradition and have restored the integrity of Humayun Tomb's World Heritage Site. The Aga Khan Trust for Culture, with co-funding of the World Monuments Fund and in partnership with the Archaeological Survey of India, undertook the conservation of Isa Khan's tomb, mosque and gateway during 2011-2013. Tile work on the canopies and the facade will be restored in 2014.
Thank you.